Good morning students. Once again I welcome you all in today's online class of biology. Students, before starting with today's topic, just have a brief recapitulation of the topics which we have covered till now. We have discussed in our previous videos about discovery of cell, the various shapes and sizes of cell, about the structural organization of cell, that is the cell is made up of mainly these three: plasma membrane, nucleus, cytoplasm. And we have discussed about the features and functions of plasma membrane. We have discussed about cytoplasm, and today we will be discussing about the nucleus. Yesterday we also discussed about the differences and similarities between plant cells and animal cells. So now today we will be discussing about nucleus, its basic structure, the ultrastructure of nucleus, as well as the differences between the prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells and the similarities too. So let's start. Nucleus, that is one of the important part, or we can say brain of the cell, like a CEO of a company, or you can say the prime minister of a country, or the vice principal of a school, right? So same way, nucleus is the brain of the cell. The main structural components of nucleus are there in this diagram. Let's have a look and then we'll discuss them all one by one. This is the basic structure of nucleus, students. The outer membrane, as in cell, the outer membrane was cell membrane or plasma membrane. So same way in the nucleus, this outer membrane is called the nuclear membrane. Then these small holes which you can see here are the nuclear pores. Yes. Next, these thread-like structures which you see here, these are the chromatin. These X shapes, rods, these are the chromosomes. And this in center, the granular structure is nucleolus. Right. Now coming on to the basic, this is the structure of nucleus. Now coming on to the basic features of nucleus. What is all it is carrying in the functions? It contains all the genetic information. Yes. Whichever characteristics you are carrying from your ancestors, the genes, you know that, the inheritance, like you get brown eyes or the brown hair or any other feature, long height. So these are all carried with the genes, and this is the nucleus which is carrying all this genetic information. It takes part in transmission of genetic information from the parent cell to the daughter cell. So these characteristics which are forwarding, we are forwarding it to the next generation from the previous one. This is all by the transmission of this. Next, the division of nucleus. You know, whenever a cell divides, you must have seen the unicellular organisms, amoeba and others. When a cell divides, the nucleus always divides, right? So in the cell division, there is the division of nucleus also. Then a very important thing, ribosomes are formed in the nucleus. Now, why are ribosomes important? We have discussed yesterday. Ribosomes are there for the protein synthesis. So, see how much important things are there carried by the nucleus, like the prime minister's work. I gave you the examples from the daily life, the real life. The vice principal of school, the PM of the country, the CEO of a company. The important functions they all are holding, the same way here, the nucleus is holding all these important functions. Now, based on the presence and absence of this nuclear membrane, this outer covering. See students, whenever you draw a drawing, a painting, a poster sort of thing, why we used to outline the things? If I am drawing some mountains or some houses, scenery sort of thing, why we used to outline those? Yes, because we want to highlight them. They will be more brightly coming to the eyes, focused, right? Same way here, the work is of nuclear membrane. If nuclear membrane won't be there, or the membrane, like the cell membrane, if the membrane won't be there, what about these organelles which are there in between? They will be floating everywhere, right? So to bound them, there is an outer membrane. So if this nuclear membrane won't be there, there will be no distinct nucleus. All these parts of nucleus which we are seeing here, they will be floating anywhere in this cell, right? So, based on the presence and absence of this nuclear there will be a nesting nucleus, and if nuclear membrane won't be there, there won't be a nesting nucleus. If in your drawing you have highlighted everything, you will definitely see specifically it is mountain, it is river, it is house. But if you have not highlighted, your drawing will be complete messed up. From where the river is starting, the mountains are starting, it won't be highlighted, right? It will be a mess. So same way, if there is no nuclear membrane, these all things will be messed up. Now based on this, some cells have the nuclear membrane, some cells don't have. So we have differentiated these two types of cells on the presence or absence of nuclear membrane. They are the prokaryotic cell, the primitive ones, and the eukaryotic cell, the new ones. Again, giving you a real life example, compare the primitive ones, the prokaryotic ones, with your ancestors, the 19th century people, and compare the eukaryotic ones with yourself, this generation, 21st century, right? Now coming on the differences. The very first difference, I have already told you all that they have a distinct nucleus. Who? The eukaryotes. And the prokaryotes, they don't have a distinct nucleus. Right. Now the size. The size of these prokaryotes, the primitive ones, is very small, 1 to 10 micron. Whereas these days, these eukaryotes, these are having size of 5 to 100. Means you can compare it with any characteristic in your ancestors' list. They were not very tall, and you people are very tall ones. Okay. Now, examples are bacteria in prokaryotes. You have seen mostly unicellular ones comes in prokaryotes, right? And in eukaryotes, the plants and animals, you know they are multicellular, right? Examples we have already compared with your ancestors, the 19th century and you people. Nucleus we have discussed, they don't have a distinct nucleus, they do have a distinct nucleus. Then they lack many membrane bound organelles. Now compare these with the this technology. You people know the technology, you are techno savvy, but your ancestors, they were not techno savvy. Now related with this characteristic, that they are lacking many membrane bound organelles, whereas the eukaryotes, the new ones, they have the membrane bound organelles because they have the membranes, right? Now here the reproduction is asexually, means the methods, budding, binary fission, this regeneration, these all, fragmentation, these all are the methods which are used by the prokaryotes, the primitive ones, for the reproduction. Whereas here in eukaryotes, mitosis and meiosis, this is there. Now again, come to the real life with your 19th century and 21st. Earlier the reproduction was very simple, male, female and reproduction, but these days we have IVF technology, test tube babies, surrogacy, many methods, right? So compare. This is how you can relate the things with your real life examples and just keep in your mind about the differences. Now these were all the differences. Now I am coming on to the similarities, students. Similarities, they both have the DNA, because that is the main thing. It should be there. So DNA is there in both. What is DNA? Deoxyribose nucleic acid. And the functional unit of DNA is genes, which is carrying all the genetic information. Now, if they both contains the ribosomes, right? For protein synthesis, they both have the ribosomes. Then they both have the plasma membrane. Plasma membrane is there, means cell membrane is there in both, but nuclear membrane is not there in prokaryotes. Got it? So this is all with the differences and similarities of prokaryotes and eukaryotes. I hope this is all clear. And with that, these features of nucleus also are clear. Hopefully it's all understood. This is the outer structure of nucleus, which you cannot see under a compound microscope. If you see under the compound microscope, you will see the darkly stained parts, the cell organelles. I told you yesterday, you will see the darkly stained cell organelles and the light colored fluid, which will be light colored stain, that will be cytoplasm. So you will simply see if it's a cell under the compound microscope, these dark colored ones are the cell organelles. But here you won't be able to see the complete structure of nucleus. For that you need a high definition of microscope, that is the electron microscope. Okay, then okay, you can see this structure of nucleus. Now, the diagrams of plant cell, animal cell, the nucleus, all these you should practice. And I'll be providing you the notes with this. So just do the notes in your notebooks and just revise and keep on reading all these topics. Now in our upcoming video, we'll be discussing about the cell organism. Now our structural organization is done. Now we will be coming in the cell organelles which are present in the cytoplasm. Okay, so from the next video we will start discussing about the structure and function of particularly all the cell organelles, their diagrams as well as the structure points, their functional points. Right students? So hope this is all clear to you. Keep on revising, keep updating your biology. Till the next time, thank you and have a great day.